punch him. What was that?
I think it was me calling a Batmobile by accident. Matt.
Hello, Tom.
Matt Man, yeah. Matt Man, yeah, that's you.
True, you're right.
And I'm the Dark Knight. It's time for the next generation of Batman. Mm-hmm. It's the Arkham Knight. It's the PlayStation 4. It's the power of the PlayStation 4.
Just working together.
Open world video games.
Yep.
Taking down crime. One Gotham City citizen at a time. That's my fat beat. Enjoy. I have been playing quite a bit of Batman Arkham Knight, and I think that this video game is pretty cool. I'm a big fan of the Arkham series so far. I'm even an Arkham Origins apologist, you might call me. That game was fine. It wasn't that great, but it was more Batman, and I like that because I think that this style of open world, Batman game is quite a lot of fun.
Yeah,
and
exactly.
I want to jump in here and show you what I think of the new Batman. As you see, I've been playing quite a bit on this file here. We'll start out with on Bleak Island, which it's pretty. It's an apt name for somewhere that's located in Gotham City. It's just very bleak and dark and gray, and everyone's kind of sad. But yeah, we'll jump in here. I'll show you what's new, and then maybe we'll jump ahead a little bit, and I'll show you some of the stuff that you can look forward to if you play Batman Arkham Knight for a while.
You should
play this game. It's really cool. But also, first, right out of the gate, this season pass that they're offering, apparently they're saying it's like 6 months of extra content. It's going to be like a bunch of extra Batgirl missions and Nightwing and Robin and Catwoman missions, like the other characters.
That's cool.
It's $45.
Jesus, another game.
It is the most expensive season pass, I think, that there ever has been so far.
That's crazy.
It's a little pricey. I don't know if it's going to be worth it. I remember the extra content for Arkham City not being all that worth it. I thought that was kind of like the worst mission in the game.
Oh, really?
Yeah, not super great. Plus, there's all the retailer exclusive stuff with this game.
Yeah.
Like, if you go to your local EB Games, you get the Harley Quinn mission. If you go to Best Buy, I don't know, you get to play as like Clock King or something.
Oh,
I don't know.
Jesus.
Like, that's not real. Don't listen to me there. No one wants to play as actually, I would love to play as the Clock King. That sounds like the dumbest and best thing in the world.
Yeah.
So right now, this is very early goings in the game. I just unlocked my cool new Batman suit that lets me do fear takedowns and such.
Yeah.
But I'll try and I'll run around the open world a little bit and just show you. Check out this suit.
Oh yeah, you literally just upgraded it. That's sweet.
Look at my cool suit.
It's so cool.
Look at that. It's like
Iron Man Batman mashup.
Exactly, like triple carbon fibers liquid Batman suit that lets me take down three guys at a time. Look at me triple gliding. Look at that.
Damn, that's
look at you rocket off that stuff. Oh, you're so quick. Oh, that guy works for the Riddler. I can tell because he's green.
Get him.
I'm gonna get all these guys.
God damn.
Yeah, just show them what I can do. Don't mess with me. Yeah, here. I'll talk to you in a second. You don't want none of this.
Oh, there it goes.
Batman doesn't kill, but he will put you right into the pavement.
That's the first time I've seen this game do something like that.
Yeah, this game has been pretty stable, actually. The PS4 version, anyway. Cannot speak to the PC version, which is apparently broken beyond belief
right now.
It is totally fucked.
Oh, I didn't know that.
Five ways from Sunday.
Wow.
Yeah, I guess they're talking about it being, a third-party outside PC dev team. Which
yeah,
exactly. Like, the PC port just kind of shit its pants. But, I mean, look at this game, though. Like, I mean, I'm sure eventually it'll look better on the PC, but, I mean, just the fidelity of, like, the way that Batman's cape moves there, and just the water on the cape, and just everything is shiny and wet because it's always raining in Gotham City.
Yeah.
The neon lights, the draw distance, like, everything about this looks really, really good. You'll say what you want about those delays, but, I mean, like, it came out looking really good.
I'd rather complete game and wait for it than
Absolutely. Like, so many games ship with known ship. Okay. Here's one of the things that I wanted to talk about. You'll see, once Alfred's done telling me about mutilated bodies, I will open up the mission select here.
Okay.
I don't remember if this is how it was in other games, so maybe you do. You can let me know.
Okay.
But when you open up the mission select here, you got your main mission, obviously. You have your Riddler challenge. You have, like, rescue these firemen.
Yeah.
And you have, these extra... This is just basically your whole completion, and then the, like, other side missions down here.
Okay.
When I first started this game, I wasn't quite sure how I felt about this. Like, I did a couple of the side missions, and then Alfred was just like, yeah, listen for opera music, and you might be able to find another mutilated body, and you can solve a crime. And I was growing concerned that I would have to, like, randomly scour Gotham City looking for, opera music, which is just something I had no interest in doing.
Yeah.
As I played a little bit more, eventually, like, once you complete main missions, eventually you will get just mission markers for these or intel where Alfred will be like, hey, there's mutilated bodies on top of this building, and Batman, you should probably go check that out or something. I don't know.
Yeah.
And then it'll just give you a mission marker to go do that. So, but I just stumbled across this right now. Like, I didn't have a mission marker for this. I just happened to fall down here. So if you are just exploring the world, you can totally find this stuff
out
there.
That's pretty cool.
Like, it is just out there. So it's kind of like, you know, in your hands, with, like, however you want to do it. If you want to go out there and find that stuff, go find it. If you want to just, like, have the game deliver it out to you, you can do that too.
Yeah.
Exactly.
That's pretty cool.
Yeah, I like the way they handled that, and I think, actually, like, doing the story missions and then letting it open it up, it paces the game really well. Like, I find that I'm getting these at a pace that I can sort of digest them naturally. These ones are just kind of like, check out this weird mannequin body who doesn't have a dork, and then, like, find out what's wrong with him. This guy, for instance, has an Illuminati symbol on his arm.
Scar tissue on the upper arm.
He's a big fan of the Red Hot Chili Peppers.
20 years ago, this was
and
a batch of...
I will be here all week. And then this guy also has, like, some sort of a bean in his arm.
Small group of racketeers known as the Bloodhidden Six.
Talk for a while. I'm glad that Kevin Conroy is still getting work. I think he's the best Batman voice.
Oh, for sure.
Pacemaker fitted through the right.
And I should also inform people that going forward, if you like don't want any spoilers, we're probably going to jump ahead a bit.
Yeah.
And beware that there may be some spoilers. But also the way that this game has been like revealing itself, if you're into Batman at all, you can kind of call right from the get-go, like, what's going to happen.
Mm-hmm.
So, nothing...
We'll be clear when we get to the spoilery part anyway. So.
Yeah, we will try to do our best to be clear of that stuff. But yeah, it's... that's one of those side missions. Basically, check out these mutilated bodies and then try and track down the serial killer. But there's a ton of different side missions in this game. Like, there's a lot of stuff in this game.
Yeah, there really is.
Let's go to Ace Chemicals, because I think I have a mission to do down there. Sweet. Batman has to go to work.
Try and find a connection between the two victims I found, Alfred. There has to be something linking them together.
I'll try my best. Alfred, do my work for me. I'm busy. Yeah, just, like, getting around is, like...
Launch.
I know. And I'll show you. You can upgrade that quite a bit.
That's awesome.
I will show you where I am a little later on. But it is... That's just sound coming out of my controller.
Oh, weird.
That feature still exists on the PlayStation 4. Pretty useful. Pretty good feature. So, another thing that we have in Gotham City that was not available in Arkham City. I'm trying to get it here. Come on. Make me look cool, Batman. Oh. There we go. You can kind of call your Batmobile at any point and just fall into it. And you know what? It works 98% of the time. I've had a couple times where I've just, like, fallen, like, on a building because I didn't aim it properly. I've had a couple times where the car freaks out because it seems like it's actually, like, rendering in-world. Like, it actually exists in the world.
That's insane.
But, yeah, it works most of the time, like, launching over buildings and stuff.
That's so cool.
Batman's got his sweet car that can strafe, and it turns into a Transformer from War for Cybertron when you do this because you're just kind of moving around like this. They integrate the Batmobile into puzzles quite a bit. Like, later in the game, like, you're maneuvering tight spaces and, like, using your engine to electrify stuff and, you know, navigating spaces, especially for the Riddler challenges. You were using your car quite a bit.
No way, okay.
So they have definitely integrated that. And you know what? How you feel about this game as opposed to, like, Arkham City may be directly correlated to how much you enjoy driving the Batmobile. Because they use it quite a bit.
Yeah.
And if you're not okay with that, then you might not like this as much. But I actually think it's really fun to drive.
Yeah, so far I really like driving the Batmobile.
Yeah, you picked it up. What do you think so far? Like, you're enjoying it?
Yeah, I'm only like, I'm just got past this mission, but I'm really enjoying it so far.
Yeah,
it's really fun.
I think this is, like, in terms of the open world Batman games, I think this is probably my favorite one.
Yeah, I can see that for sure.
I am still, like, I think Arkham Asylum is, like, that is the be-all and end-all for me. That is one of my favorite games of all time.
Okay.
But, in terms of the open world ones, these ones are really cool.
Yeah.
Oh no, the helicopter's being piloted by Troy Baker.
So basically, is Scarecrow the main bad guy in this game,
yes,
or is it Arkham Knight? Or?
So Arkham Knight is working with Scarecrow,
okay,
and
gotcha.
Like, basically Scarecrow is like, you know, you. This may be a familiar plot point to you if you are familiar with Batman, but Scarecrow wants to make everyone in Gotham City afraid.
Okay.
So he wants to release his fear toxin all over Gotham City, and he evacuates Gotham City of civilians, so it's kind of overrun by criminals right now, because, of course, because, you know, why would there be civilians?
You're driving a Batmobile, you can't run them over.
Yeah, exactly, you can't use your weird electrified cow catcher to move civilians out of the way.
Yeah.
But, yeah, why would Batman be protecting civilians in a city?
Right.
No, it's, so yeah, he's evacuated everyone, but it becomes clear that, he had always planned for that, and he's going to drop fear toxin that spreads way farther than Gotham City. And he just evacuated everyone so that, you know, it was easier for him to do what he was going to do.
Okay.
But, yeah, the Arkham Knight just seems to have some sort of a grudge against Batman for some reason.
Yes.
Seems to be kind of a little pissy for some reason. I don't know. Maybe I won't say who I think it is, but I think it's pretty obvious who the Arkham Knight is.
Okay.
But, yeah, he seems to have a bit of a chip on his shoulder. You know,
some
history with Batman, yeah. But just the way that the Arkham Knight talks, it's like, okay, well, come on, guys, you're like, lean into that a little thick.
Yeah.
There's some really interesting stuff that comes out of that story, though, later on, that I'm really enjoying.
Sweet.
As much as I like Arkham Asylum 2, I think the way that this game delivers its story and the story beats in this game are the most intriguing. Like, I think this is the most engaging story from any of the Arkham games so far.
That's awesome.
Yeah, it's like, it's super enjoyable. What am I supposed to do here? Survey the area.
You have to go look to the left.
There's a lot of threats here.
Yeah.
To deal with.
Oh, there were
five soldiers, each one armed and dangerous.
Hmm.
Before I can access that terminal, I'll need to take them down.
All right, sounds fun. So it's the game is familiar. Like, if you've played an Arkham game before, it plays like an Arkham game. They have added some really cool stuff in here. I'll try and do one of these sweet new takedowns because I think they're pretty fun and one of the main additions to the combat in the game. But it totally feels like Arkham City, just faster, more polished, I would say.
Yeah.
There's some more stuff in there, but I mean, core, you're still doing like your Predator missions where you're taking down guys without being seen. You know, the free flow combat is still here, and it's still really fun to do. And I think it's like, a lot of games have adopted that. I think it's still probably the best combat in games right now. Whoa, so what's that, Batman?
Yeah, I've always loved the combat in these games. It's amazing.
Yeah, it feels really good. Like, that's the thing. And there's a reason that so many people like adopt that, right? Because there's not. Like, I don't know, I'm not a game designer, I can't think of anything that would be better than this. Someone will eventually come up with something better, but for right now, I think this is probably the most fun combat in a game.
Definitely.
No, don't come over here, though. What if you didn't?
Yeah, I'm good.
Yeah. That guy was stupid. He didn't account for Batman. Let's see if I can...
They never do.
No. That's the thing. Like, I've been roaming around these cities for a number of years now. You would think at some point they'd be like, maybe we should... I don't know. Maybe we should check those gargoyles. So, yeah. You take one guy down. It slows down. You can aim at another guy and take him down because you have this new suit, is the conceit.
Right.
Really fun to do. Just feels really good.
And how many... Is it up to four guys?
So, initially it is up to three, I believe.
Oh, okay.
You can upgrade that so you can take down four and then five guys.
Oh, cool.
I don't think I've purchased any of that yet, because I've been kind of playing this like it's old Arkham, and I just kind of wander into those situations and don't really like go looking for them.
Yeah,
there's still that guy over there. Come here, jerk, stupid thug. See, what Gotham City needs is a better class of thugs.
Yeah,
look at this
that's
guy
true.
Walking around.
Amateur hour.
Yeah, exactly. These jobbers down here that are tasked with taking out the bat. I am the knight.
It's safe to access the terminal.
All right, where's this computer at?
Right there.
There we go. Luckily, I have that sweet detective vision that just, you know, kind of highlights everything ever. Right. Touch it. Batman, touch the computer.
Let's see.
This mission gets pretty cool when you get the Batmobile involved.
Yeah, I really like using the remote to have Batman in one spot and control the Batmobile in another spot.
Yeah, it's really cool.
It's pretty fun. Security protocols. Like, there is the most stuff in this game. Like, I find that I am experimenting with the different gadgets the most in this game,
which is
nice. And they've made it easy. Like, they've given you like a radial menu and everything, which is makes everything, you know, quick and easy to access. Again, I don't remember if that was in the other games because it's been a while since I played Arkham City.
It kind of was.
It was like a D-pad thing, right? Yeah. Exactly. So I just think this, yeah. But I mean, like the whole quick gadget stuff in combat still all there.
Yeah.
Obviously. Alright, what am I doing now, Oracle? talking and playing video games at the same time, Oracle. Fight these guys. Alright.
Oh, I think we're supposed to get to the... Yeah, there you go.
Here we go. Alright, time for me to be, like, bad at the combat while I talk. Get over there! Nope!
Oh.
It's fine. Oh. Just freak out, Batman!
Yeah. I like the little last-minute counter things you can do, too.
Yeah, like, and, yeah, the last-minute counter is the, like, the throwing the batarang at the guy who's gonna run at you.
Yeah.
Yeah, the last-minute counters where they, like, it does more damage is really cool.
Right.
Oh! Ninjas! Batman hates ninjas.
Batman's worst enemy.
Yeah. What's that guy doing? Come on.
Just jumping off the other guy's head.
Super Mario Brothers ninjas. I also like that if you're holding in a direction when you counter them, you'll kind of throw guys.
Yeah.
It's a new thing in the game. Oh. Batman lost his momentum, which always feels terrible.
I was really hoping you can take people's weapons in this game.
Yeah.
And I was hoping you could grab their swords, but you can't.
I was hoping for that, too, and then so I realized cool. That wouldn't have made any sense for Batman. But a lot of guys in the city carrying around bats, which, you
exactly,
know, gives a new meaning to Batman.
Oh, true.
Yeah, I'm just walking around clubbing dudes in the head with a bat. Batman should have been doing that all along.
Yeah.
If I use the crane now, it will alert the tanks.
Oh, of course, yes, those...
You gotta get to the highest point of that building.
Right. Don't want to alert those tanks, that's for sure. I don't use ladders. Fuck ladders.
Yeah, ladders are for idiots.
Yeah, exactly. If I had a grapnel, I would not use a ladder.
I can release the bat scanner.
I don't use ladders now because they scare me and it hurts my legs. Like, what if I fell off a ladder? A. B. Ladders are always, like, right up against a wall and my knees keep hitting the wall.
Yeah.
And I have dandy knees. I can't be hitting them against a wall the whole time. Oh, yeah, that's right. This stuff. There's a guy. It feels like there's more of this stuff in the game, too. Like, there's this, there's, like, the weird things you're doing where you're, blade runnering through old video files and, like, finding, clips of people getting kidnapped or reconstructing fingerprints and stuff like that. It just seems like there is more of that in this game.
Right.
Which, I've actually kind of, dug some of the puzzles in here. They're super, super simple, but, I've enjoyed what I've done. Gotcha.
Nice.
It worked. There are 5 ID markers showing up within the facility.
Yeah, they're probably all dead.
Yeah.
There's probably, like, one of those guys left. Cool.
Nice.
There's... Like other Batman games, there's not a lot of stuff you're doing in here that just isn't the coolest thing all the time.
I know, yeah.
That's where this game gets me over, like, most other open-world games is I want to do all of the side missions.
Oh, I know, yeah, same here.
It's so perfectly paced, and everything you're doing is fun, whereas, like, any other open-world game, it's like, I don't want to fucking do open-world races. Like,
yeah.
I hate open-world races. And in this one, just, like, driving in tunnels going, like, around walls and stuff, it feels... It's really fun.
It is, yeah.
Take it. Take it. You take it.
Nice.
Let's see if I can... What do you know about lights? Haha!
Whoa,
environmental
sick.
Takedowns, also new.
Holy shit.
Camera freaking out when you get a guy in a corner, though. Not new. That is still... That is Batman Arkham
Classic
City tradition.
Batman, yeah.
Classic Batman. See, I called it. Look at that guy.
Straight dead.
Article. Yeah, I called it. Having played this mission like a few hours ago.
Militia comms network. You'll be able to listen in on any channel.
Good job, Babs. From now on. What a hack.
Thanks, Oracle. I found a way to get the Batmobile into the compound.
It's weird. Like, it's something I'm noticing now going back after having played for a while. Batman just starts to look kind of haggard by the end. Like, he's looking all clean-shaven and fresh-faced here.
Yeah.
Like, later on, he is just looking, like, just grim.
That's awesome.
Yeah. They do sort of the same stuff they did in Arkham City, where his cape
right.
is all tattered near the end and stuff.
That's pretty sweet.
It just looks weathered. Like, Batman has been through some shit. Alright!
So here's the thing you were talking about, where you can control the Batmobile while you're inside.
Yeah, so Batman's over there, and I'm just driving it with my remote. You also have, like, a winch, which you'll use to do, like, environmental puzzles, which... Apparently, the roads in Gotham City are made of jelly.
Yeah. Totally bendable.
Yeah. No wonder it's always getting destroyed. Well, I guess it's probably cheaper to make this the roads out of, like, clay, since they just, like, get killed all the time.
Yeah, that's true. There's always, like, super villains messing shit up.
Exactly. So here's the car combat. Like, I guess Batman knows where they're gonna shoot before they shoot. You get out of the way of the red lines, so you don't get hit. Because you build up, this is basically the equivalent of, like, your combo meter when you're fighting on foot. You see that green bar building up around the reticle?
Yep.
That means I have a secondary weapon. So I launch that that missile over there, and that's, like, a quick takeout for one of these tanks.
It's pretty sweet.
It's pretty cool. You upgrade some more weapons for the tank later on, which you'll build up more weapons, more dangerous weapons. I think right now I can do up to 4 of those missile takedowns, but not really necessary for right now.
Right.
All right, made quick work of those guys.
Nice.
Get out of there. All right, let's take care of some of these tanks.
All of those tanks are supposed to be unmanned, right?
Yes. Yeah, that's the thing. Like, they've taken some, like, artistic license with Batman doesn't kill. Like, when you're shooting dudes on the street, like, you're using non-live rounds.
Yeah.
Which is like, yeah, if you're shooting guys with beanbags out of a 60mm cannon, like, they're still gonna fucking die. Like, they take one of those things to the throat, and then, like, they're just, they're dead on the spot. Like, it just doesn't seem like he cares all that much.
Right.
Like, you can run over guys, but you don't run over them. It just kind of ushes them out of the way with, like, a zap of electricity.
Yeah.
It's more funny than anything else, honestly. Like, all those tanks are just drones, so that's when you're using, like, actual explosives.
Exactly.
Like this. Like this looks like it's still pretty powerful.
Oh, yeah. Just knocks him out totally. And then...
Batman will never kill.
I love how the Batmobile just destroys everything in its path, though.
It's great. And that's, like, there's collision on stuff, but basically you are just crushing everything. Like, you are just demolishing everything in your sight. It's great. Hey, hi, guys. You should not capture Ace Chemical Workers.
No.
Because Batman's going to come find you.
Learned.
Yeah, by now. Hey, it's me. It's Batman. Coming through this door.
God, you're here.
I'm here to help. Uh-oh.
Oh, shit. Go, go, go. Run out.
There he is. Big reveal.
Damn.
Cool design. I think he looks pretty ballin'.
Keep your guns trained on
it. Is this Troy Baker in there?
Yeah, I wish.
Open fire. Troy Baker voices like 1,000 guys in this game, too.
That's so awesome.
He's the Arkham Knight, he's Harvey Dent later on, too, which is like, that's weird. But I just mean, like...
Is Nolan North still Penguin?
Nolan North is still Penguin,
yeah. Nice, that's awesome. Please.
But I just love that, like... Leave him out of this. Like, the way he's talking right now is like, I don't know. I'm trying so hard not to give things away, but
yeah.
I just want to say who I think it is. Like, I know how you think. Of course you do. Shit ass. Like, the Arkham Knight should just be called Butthurt Man. That's who he should be. He just sounds like, I hate you.
He's real upset.
He's really mad at Batman for something. Who knows what? No, probably not, though.
Aw, shit.
Take it.
That's
jerks.
Awesome. Damn, son. Oh, Batmobile assistant takedown.
Yep. Build this up. This is my favorite partner, my Batmobile.
It's so cool. I really love doing that.
I think I took everyone out before I could do an assisted takedown.
You're too good.
I'm too great at video games, specifically Batman.
Yep.
I mean, to be fair, I've been doing this kind of combat for 10 years now.
Right.
Like, when was the first? When was Arkham Asylum? Like 2007.
Yeah, something like that. Yeah.
They've been running the plant for hours. They brought in trucks, weapons.
Unless I recognize this guy's voice too, but I'm not exactly sure who it is.
They knew exactly what they were doing. He's producing his toxin on a massive scale.
I probably don't. Probably just talking out of my ass. I do that so frequently.
We're talking about a gas cloud that could cover the entire eastern seaboard. Where do I find Scarecrow? I got no idea.
All well, I know then you're no help to me. Ahead with his I'll leave you here.
Break his arm, Batman.
he's holding out on you.
I'll stop him. But first, I'm getting you out of here. Wait by the Batmobile.
If it's all the same to you, I don't wanna, because the thing looks like... That looks like he's gonna kill me?
Not It's worse than I thought.
Batman's got like the new Apple Watch.
Yeah, I think it's sweet.
Big enough to cover blasting a hologram out of there. In fear toxin.
Take your men and get out of here. What is technology going to catch up?
Yeah, yeah. I don't know. I've been asking myself that for the last couple days. Like, I just want a hologram wrist thing that, you know, Skype people on.
Yeah.
Walk around the city. Solve crimes. Let me get back to work, James.
Just leveling up left, right, and center.
Yeah, but the upgrade points, like I was telling you before, like I have to let it build up for quite a while because like getting one or two upgrade points, like it's not not really worth it.
Yeah. Militia tanks all over the city. Gotham is
overrun. If I don't stop Scarecrow's mom, let's no city to save.
Nice.
Let's figure this out here. Woo! Maybe I won't complete this whole mission. Maybe jump ahead a little bit. I don't think it's necessary to show the whole thing here.
Yeah.
I'd like to
seems like we're covering most of the
I'm just giving away these things. Hot puzzle tips. Like you know, when you play through Batman, Arkham Knight yourself, you're gonna wanna make sure you use this crane to make a ramp so you can get to the other side there. It's I like to line it up so it's perfect on. You're gonna get the jump right away. If you're following along at home, I want you to make sure that you're you may want to drop off the civilian first. I don't know if you have to, but I like to do that. You know what? Let's jump ahead a little bit and maybe cut here and then come back in a second when we are bigger and stronger Batman.
Oh yeah.
Woo! All right, we're here. We jumped over into my other save file. Where check me out on Batman. I can do this 5 times. Look at how fast I go.
Goddamn.
Woo! Rocket off of that stuff.
So cool. Show them like launching out of the Batmobile too. I think that's like the coolest thing ever.
All right.
Like while you're driving.
Yeah, sure. Let me just fall back into the Batmobile here really quick. Nope. Didn't work because I landed on this box.
Damn it.
That's what I mean. Like sometimes it'll just land on a thing like that. But
so far that hasn't happened to me.
It
seems like it just kind of depends on.
Exactly. Yeah. It's just. I mean, if I was aiming it more carefully, it probably wouldn't happen. But I mean, like.
Right.
Woo!
That's so cool.
So I'll just fly away a little bit.
You get so much speed off that.
You get awesome. So much speed. And, like, look how much height you can get off of it, too, though. And then,
so
like,
cool.
Even when you dive bomb and you pull back up, like, just look, you. It just feels like you get a lot more height in this one than you did in the last game.
Yeah.
But, yeah, and then you can just, like, is it going to land on top of a building? No, it's good.
Oh, you're good.
But right back in, and then you're just going. You're just fucking away. Like, it feels so good. It's really cool.
It is awesome.
Take out some of these guys and then maybe go find another side mission or something to do.
Yep.
And try and find something with the dual combat. And
yeah,
then,
that'd be cool.
Because that's like the other new thing in the game. I'm trying to think of everything new that's here so that I can show it off.
There's so much in this game.
Yeah, there's a lot in here. So if I'm forgetting anything, we can maybe do something again another day. But right now this is... Direct hit! Yeah!
Psionis in the street. Nice.
Yeah. I love these games.
Black Mass?
Yes. These games are always filled with like their little nods to something in comic books.
Ace Chemicals has been in like every game.
Yeah. I have an EMP blast, I guess. Cool. There's something new. There we go. We're showing it off already.
Damn. Did you just use it?
Yep.
Oh, sweet.
Just kind of exploded there. Yeah.
I love
it. Look at this.
Literally just demolish cars.
You just crunch everything in your way. Like, it feels really good. Like, again, like open world games, I find that I don't often want to do a lot of the driving, but I mean, if you give me one car and that car is the Batmobile, like, you know, I'm
goddamn gonna drive it.
Woo!
That's so cool.
Oh!
Oh, nice.
Hey, what do you work for, the Riddler?
Go punch him. What was that?
I think it was me calling a Batmobile by accident. I got your friend. Oh, nope, guess I'm starting this mission. not let's say what I wanted to do.
The source of the seismic activity.
I did it, Alfred.
Increasing in frequency. I know what it is, and it's not good.
Is it plant? Oh, it's tanks. Oh, it is!
Oh,
it's plants and tanks!
Nice! Good call.
Yeah! Also, I'm mad! I'm still mad at Batman.
It's time for Scarecrow to pay for what he did to me.
I hope you're ready. He's going to throw everything he's got at us.
I'll wreck his little tin toys.
I don't maybe want to do this mission right now. Is there a way that I can get out of this mission?
There's gotta be. I think if you just select a new mission to,
they're all kind of booked off right now,
I need to save
I want to see if I can just,
There's gotta be a way.
Yeah, let's go to my last save here and just. It said it was a minute ago. It's probably just gonna start me right at the fucking checkpoint. Yeah, surprise you guys. Joker is kind of here, kind of not really. That's a story beat again. They're you know, some spoilers.
Right.
May await.
Yeah, we are in the a little further in the game now, so.
Yeah. I'll try and stay away from any main story beats. I just want to kind of just go around the world a little bit more, maybe show a couple more gadgets that you'll get, and then maybe call it a day.
Sweet.
You should all play this game. If you like the Batman games, of course, then I think you should give it a try. So I'll just maybe see where this takes me, and then go from there.
Alpha target just hit a Diamondback. Armor breached.
Yeah, I don't know. That guy just was not having a great time.
No.
The combat here is fine. This is my least favorite part of the game. I don't know. It's not super interesting and it's not super difficult.
Right.
It's not really challenging. It's get out of the way of where they're shooting and.
You have so long to dodge.
Exactly. Yeah. It's never really all that dire. Yeah. It's kind of just you know. Shunt out of the way, and as long as there's not something red around there, then you're usually fine.
Yeah.
But also, you can hack a guy.
Oh, that's sweet.
No, that guy works for me.
No way.
Yeah, because they're all in man drones, so. I'm talking about how this is the easiest thing in the world, and I'm just getting shot all the hell. Of course I am.
Target strike.
Just die. And then, it's they don't make it, much more difficult to fight these guys. It's just they throw more guys at you.
Right.
Which is,
because it looks like it's pretty much the same enemies from when I was
playing. Exactly, it is. They have more guns, and there's more of them.
Yeah.
It's just, it's still not all that difficult.
Right.
Take it.
Nice.
I probably didn't kill that guy. Oh, it did. It's fine because when I kill the guys, the Batmobile just auto regenerates, which only happens after I take out a number of guys for some reason.
That makes sense.
If you have that technology, I don't know why you just wouldn't use that all the time. Okay, there we go. Now I can just go back and do regular side missions. I think that was just some bullshit right there. Or do I still have to do something? Let me.
I need to stay.
Of course, I have to stay and protect Ivy. Never mind. Let's go protect Poison Ivy. She's got giant plants.
Wow.
She doesn't need
yeah,
protecting.
I think she's fine.
Oh, it's this stuff. I don't know if you've done any of this yet.
I have no idea.
It's this is what I like to call Batmobile stealth sections.
Oh my god, that's hilarious.
Yeah. It's me getting up behind a tank and shooting it, and then other tanks like, "Hey, don't do that." He's not there. Destroy everything here. Oh, god damn it. Yeah, it's just Batmobile waiting around a corner for this guy to turn around. it's
that's hilarious.
It's super silly.
Nice.
We've lost the Cobra. Maintaining search.
It's just when there's five of them, it's just kind of annoying. I don't know. this is not what I really want to be doing right now, but I mean, this is what the Batman experience is, so you're gonna buy it, make sure you know that you're gonna have to do this at least three times.
Yeah.
Can still drive around for a while until you get close to somebody, and then see if I can drop behind this guy.
Nice. Did you just land right on him?
No, I landed right behind him. He didn't seem to notice too good.
Nice. Just a huge tank landing behind him.
Yeah. You know, it's an unmanned drone. He doesn't know. He can't hear.
Oh, that's true.
He can only see with his lasers. Fuck.
Uh-oh.
Yeah, these guys are really powerful, so you can take two hits from them.
Oh wow!
So you kind of have to get away really quick if they do spot you. Gotcha. But they're kind of like Metal Gear Solid guards in that they don't seem to care after a second. So
okay.
Yeah, once they turn orange, they've kind of given up. I think.
Gotcha.
Yep. Perfect. Nuh-uh.
Oh, man.
No!
Oh, my god.
No. Okay, good, it's fine. I'm very mobile as a Batman tank.
Taking a hit. Whoop. Converting two cobras now.
Whoa! Oh, my oh god! Ah! What are you doing? No!
Oh no.
Okay. Man.
That was crazy.
That tank didn't know what to do. Just walk on by, man. Just tank on by.
Target disappeared. He's there. Find him.
Man, stop. Man, come on now. What are you... Please. Stop it!
Oh my god.
Stop!
There it is.
Oh, that was tense. I didn't like that at all. Yeah, let's get right behind this guy. The true nightmare is at the end when Batman finds out that all these actually had men in them. They weren't unmanned at all. That was the Arkham Knight's plan the whole time.
That'd be nuts.
Yeah, I wrote this game.
No way.
Yeah, that's me. I'm Bob Kane. Hi. Suck it, tank! I like the way they look when they explode, those particle effects, yeah. Like the purple explosion. I think it looks really pretty.
That is really cool. Oh, is that a Riddler puzzle or something?
Yeah, probably. Yeah, it looks like it. I'll deal with that later. I always leave the Riddler puzzles to the very end.
Yeah.
Okay. Can I do other missions right now? Or yes. Okay, yes. Let's do a dual play mission, and then we can call it, because these are really cool.
Sweet.
Have you seen much of this yet?
No, I haven't really seen any of it.
Then you are in for a pleasant surprise. This is, yeah, just exactly. Just zap him out of the way.
He's probably fine.
Yeah, no, it's fine. Batman doesn't kill, right? So he's probably, based on that rule alone, I bet he's totally cool.
Yeah.
Shit, I fucked up. I fucked up, you guys.
What is this?
I'm not supposed to chase him with the Batmobile.
Oh.
If I go away, it should just respawn. Are you kidding me? Let's go back. Let's try and restart that really quick.
Oh my god.
4 minutes? Are you kidding me? Is that like before I was done that other mission? If it is, I'm gonna be upset.
That would be hilarious.
It would be not funny at all. Yeah, okay, good, it worked. Matt, it worked.
You did it.
Go
get that shithead.
Let's do it not in the Batmobile this time, though.
What if you did, though?
That's a good... Yeah, you know what? Good point. Pick me up. Never mind. Go. Yeah, just the quickness that you can do that stuff with is really impressive. That they managed to pull that off. Like when they were talking about this stuff, like I was like, nah, that's never gonna work.
It's a really ambitious game.
It is. They've packed a lot of stuff into here.
Yeah, a lot of really cool stuff.
And you know, kind of one of those old tropes about talking about video games, but the level of polish here is fucking second to none. It is crazy how much stuff is in here.
It's pretty awesome.
So, first of all, I got all these gadgets now.
Bam.
So let's use my my tracker to keep an eye on these guys. And then I scare them away, but not with the Batmobile, so that I can chase them.
That's pretty sweet.
Yep. And then you just kind of Assassin's Creed them for a while.
That's awesome.
But unlike in Assassin's Creed, you can fly, making these not shitty. Because tailing missions in Assassin's Creed are just not fun.
No.
Stop shooting me. I'm trying to do something. If I can't complete this mission because I'm getting shot at by a drone, I'm going to be very cross.
You got this.
Nah, he's probably gone by now. Everyone from Gotham City is actually from New York. what we should probably do is drive back to the hideout and talk about it a lot on this radio, because...
I thought they already knew Batman, like, spies on them from the radios.
Everyone in Gotham City is a fucking idiot.
Yeah.
All these thought, like, that's what I mean. They need a better level of thug, because everyone just seems...
That's real dumb.
Yeah. Alright, let's go back to where everyone else is. Every single thug in Gotham City has this false level of confidence that I just can't wrap my head around. Looks so cool.
It is really cool.
I'm gonna get you. Nuh-uh. You don't know that.
Penguin's hiding his weapons inside Gotham's water filtration plant. Let's hit him hard.
Let's do it, Nightwing. Nightwing's pretty cool.
Yeah, I love Nightwing.
I really liked when Nightwing was Batman for a while there.
Yeah.
Because then Damian Wayne was Robin, and then you had like a serious Robin, so but cool, kind of a jokey Batman, and it was a nice shift.
Yeah.
Remember the time that Superboy Prime punched reality so hard that Jason Todd came back to life?
Is that how he came back to life?
Sometimes it's that. Sometimes it's the Lazarus Pit.
Oh, okay.
But I think it's funnier when it's... Why am I getting shot? Oh, this jerk. Now I have no health to do this mission because this asshole.
Shit.
Yeah, that's... Like, these tanks just kind of roam around, too, so sometimes they will just get in your business and it's super annoying.
Yeah. Oh, you got some balloons on the side of the building. Is it collectible to, like, pop those?
I'm not sure. I know it was when the Joker was still, like, actually in the world, but I'm not sure if that's still the case. Hmm. I will try and pop those for you. Man, I am trying to do a side mission. This is not a good time for you to get in my business.
There's so many of them.
This is actually the most annoying thing in the world right now. Like, there's a lot of stuff in the game that's pretty dynamic, and I wish this wasn't happening right now.
Right.
I was hoping to show some of the Scarecrow stuff. Like, there's a couple scenes where, I was telling you before, it reminds me kind of PT in a weird way.
That's awesome.
They do with the Scarecrow missions, and it is delightful. Some of the stuff that they pull off. The series has always been really good about doing their Scarecrow like psychological stuff.
Definitely. Yeah.
So where the fuck am I supposed to go?
Somewhere underground.
Down?
Yeah.
I like can't access my detective vision or whatever.
Oh, how come?
I don't know. Like, I saw these guys go in here, and now I'm trying to find the... I can get in here, and then, like... Yeah, okay. I can just follow the arrow. Correct. Cool. In terms of design choices, like, I am super happy they have the arrows just, like, in-world as opposed
to
on the minimap. That is always
so much better. Yeah.
Just crunch everything on the way in here.
They just have no idea you're there.
No. Oh, they all have guns. Fuck.
Uh-oh.
But I also have guns, so... I hope this is not the only room with combat in it, because I really want to show off the,
Yeah.
The dual combat in here.
Yeah, I'm excited to see.
I still hear guys talking, so...
Mm-hmm.
Just fuck your window. Fuck your window, Batman.
This game is so cool about everything.
Oh, yeah. It's great. Everything feels really good.
Go back to where you just were.
It wants me to be, like, over here.
Oh,
it wants me to... What? What would you like from me? Am I supposed to, like...
Probably turn those down somewhere.
This? Like, what do you want me to... I feel like something got fucked up, because I can't, like, use... Detective vision or whatever.
There's probably a switch somewhere around there to close those gates. Oh, maybe not the markers right on.
Yeah, exactly. Like, I think just something got kind of fucked.
Maybe winch it? On the Batmobile?
No. Maybe? I don't know. It's like... Alright, well. Less than 1 minute ago, maybe this will fix whatever fucked
Jesus.
Up.
Jesus.
I get, hey, maybe this is good, because this is the only time I've ever seen this get, like, fucked up as much as it has been,
yeah,
so.
Wow.
Other than that, it's just been, like, some like, ragdoll freaking out, but it's been pretty stable.
Mm-hmm.
I just want to do the dual combat. I feel like it's not that much to ask.
No.
It's one of the game's coolest features. Just let me do it, please. Everyone's gonna laugh at me at how stupid I am, but... There, now I can just do... Yeah, okay,
there
now I
go.
Can do detective vision, so something was just fucking up, for sure.
Yeah.
Again, fuck your window.
There it is.
There it is. I hope I do just get to fight guys, though, because that's... Wait, what am I... What? It's still... Okay, yeah. Now, what?
What the fuck?
I really don't know what it wants me to do.
You might have to use the winch on that thing up there, like to the left.
Like one of that thing?
Yeah.
That looks like that is,
Most power thing?
Yeah. Well, maybe. That looks like a counterweight. Oh, you're right. Look at you.
I am Batman.
Smart. Yeah, Batman.
Batman.
Could it power it? No. What do you want from me, Batman?
Oh, and then maybe go to where that marker was with your Batmobile?
Yeah, I guess. It doesn't look like it wants me to.
Oh, okay.
I feel like this should just be coming down, right?
Yeah. So you can't get over to where the marker is?
Huh?
You can't get over to where that marker is?
No.
Oh, that's weird.
Yeah, right?
What the hell? That's real dumb.
Yeah, some. I feel like something...
Oh, wait.
Something got, like... hella fucked when I, power winch, but then it won't let me do, like, the...
Yeah.
There it goes. Oh, like, okay, why? Why? What is happening right now?
I have no idea. That's weird.
You guys! Alright. Okay. I think we might be able to do this.
Oh, here... Yeah, definitely.
These guys are all unarmed.
There's a lot of them.
Making this a fun combat scenario. So, you have the one... Is this... Oh, I don't see Nightwing's little bar there, so... Hey, I'll throw a chair at him! How about this big vase? No, oh, it worked.
Yeah, he got you.
He did get me. You can't argue with the results.
That's awesome.
I know, that's my favorite, that's my favorite gadget to use in combat.
That's real cool.
Get the fuck! Get! Stop! Throw it, do it, throw the vase. Fuck. I wasn't quick enough. Oh, like, this sucks. Every other time I've done one of these, I've been able to switch between Nightwing.
Hmm.
Rocksteady, if you're watching, you dropped the ball on this one.
How are you doing, man?
Yeah, Mr. Rocksteady?
Yeah, Mr. Rocksteady. Damn.
Well, let me be clear, everybody. When you do the dual combat, it's really cool. I don't know that I'm going to be able to here right now. Just get out of here, man. I feel like Batman said, Nightwing, come help me, but Nightwing just wasn't here. I wonder if the game freaked out there, because every other time you've been...
Yeah, that's super
...with
weird.
Nightwing. Anyway, I guess that's probably a good look at Batman.
Yeah.
I really want to show... Maybe I can jump into an AR mission. Maybe there's a dual combat AR mission that
yeah,
I can
that's
do.
That's a good idea.
Just to see, because that's, again, that's one of the coolest things in the game.
Mm-hmm.
It would be a shame to not show that. A shame, I say.
A damn shame.
I like that Batman draws his stupid bat when he does the explosive
jab.
No one's ever going to see it because it's going to explode right away. Every time it's got to be a stupid bat. Does Robin draw a bird? Probably.
I need to
can you
the
use their, like,
first.
Special stuff?
You can, yeah. Like, there was the one mission where I was playing as Robin and Batman at the same time, which was cool.
Oh. We got him captured.
Oh, I guess that's why Nightwing wasn't helping me.
Yep.
How does anyone get captured by the Penguin?
I know, eh? Like, come on. Out of all the villains.
Alfred, I need you to use Nightwing's tracker and isolate his location for me.
Master Grayson isn't in any danger, is he, sir?
Penguin has him.
No, oh, dear.
So yeah, no danger. Touch him with his umbrella for a while.
Yeah.
You must hurry, sir. We both know Master Grayson can be too reckless for his own good.
Fuck it. Let's just try. Let's just see if that'll let me do the dual combat.
Okay.
Hang on, Dick. I'm coming for you.
Yeah, so the Joker just kind of will appear in hallucinations for you, and just he's kind of in your head, trying to manipulate you to become him. It's pretty good. Some of the shit is pretty good.
We get it, Batman.
Yeah, Batman, your car. I know. All right. Uh-oh!
Holy shit! Alright!
Fucking goddamn it!
Good thing you didn't get in.
There's like three main... I hate you, Batman! There's like three main islands for, Gotham City. And, I have not maybe taken out as many tanks in that area as I would like to.
Do they not just keep respawning?
No, they don't keep respawning. There's like a certain number of tanks on those islands. And then eventually they just sort of deplete and it's safer to drive around, cops to be out there again, which will also reduce the amount of thugs that are in that area, I think.
Wow. That's crazy.
I'm going to try and get in that building one more time. And if my car gets attacked again, I'm going to call it because I'm getting annoyed now. Just trust me that it's cool.
Here we go.
Of course, I gotta fucking fight these guys again.
What the hell is that?
That's someone's jamming me.
Oh.
It's probably this jerk. I'm hiding pretty good.
Those jerks. Wow.
Yeah, pretty good. Anyone else? There's at least one more guy. I like this because it disarms them, and fighting guys with guns is not what I like to do in these games.
No.
Don't punch me. Alright, okay, I took out the guy who was jamming me. Just step on your dick. Dick punch. Batman's secret weapon. Hey, Joker. See, like, that's the thing, like, he'll just be kind of hanging out there sometimes, and then you'll turn away and he won't be there anymore. That's the shit that gets me kind of, like PT, that I quite enjoy.
Oh.
You're actually going to save him, aren't you? You should leave him. He deserves it. Going off on his own like that. He doesn't respect you, Bats. Never has.
Alright. If this doesn't result in dual combat, boy am I going to be embarrassed. I mean, no wonder you need weird leg braces from just that doctor down, from like, Reno 911. Yeah. Yeah. Oh, those sentries are real pieces of shit. Uh-oh.
Really?
Nuh-uh. Sorry.
Oh, nice.
Yeah. Just kind of hack him and then come over here and... It was just like the end of Aliens.
Exactly like it.
Oh. World's greatest detective can't pick a lock.
Yeah, how come Batman can't pick locks?
I don't know. Let me in. Also, strongest guy in the world.
He can rip off his metal grip, but can't kick in a door.
Yeah, seriously.
You hear that, Nightwing? Oh, you gotta have some dual combat here.
Yeah. Oh, I'm just gonna, like, probably let him out. Yeah, rescue Nightwing.
Great. That's pretty awesome.
And then we're gonna get this done. Stop hurting Nightwing!
Oh my god. That's so damn cool.
So basically, yeah, I'm playing as Nightwing. You'll see that second... See that bat symbol there?
Yeah.
That builds up as you fight. And then you just switch right away.
Wow.
Just a quick animation like that works every time. It feels really cool every time you do it.
That's so awesome.
Pick up this bat. Now I'm the Batman. Oh. And you can also just switch like that. It won't do the animation but until you build it up. But you can just switch over to Nightwing if you want.
Does the combo keep building up when you switch between things? Oh, that's sweet.
So Nightwing's just a bit faster, not quite as strong, but he's definitely faster.
Okay.
He's got his little sticks there. He's got his own they've each got their own gadget, so he's got like the electric sticks. He can use that to stun guys. I can't remember if he's got a projectile. Let's see. Yeah, he's got his like his weird little projectile there.
Cool.
Actually, let's go back to Nightwing for a second. Like, this is not the most elegant, I realize that, but I just want to see, like, what else he has. Mm-hmm. Yeah, he's got the back claw also. He's got his stick and his electric blast. So, cool. This is L2 and R2. Yeah, that's how you do it. Okay, cool.
That's really awesome.
It's just, it's one of those things, like, it's kind of innovative. Like, you never really seen something like this before, at least as far as I can remember. So, right. it's cool that it works. And, it's really fun. Really, really fun. I'm just gonna throw this at you.
Yeah, exactly.
Suck it, jerk. Ah. What? Dual team takedown, come on. There we go. It's just...
spikes him.
Yeah, exactly.
Damn.
I think that's a good place to stop.
Yeah, that was awesome.
Maybe a little bit of a longer video, but there's a lot of stuff packed into this game.
There really is.
And yeah. I'm enjoying... basically all of it, yeah. And I look forward to continue to thinking I know who the Arkham Knight is.
Right. I just want to 100% this game.
Yeah. These games are kind of like the only ones that I ever 100%.
Yeah.
And I'm looking forward to playing a lot of this game and really digging into the world and doing everything that I can, because this game is hella cool.
I think the only games I've ever 100% or 100%ed were the Batman games and...
Shadow of Mordor, which is basically a Batman game. Yeah,
to tell
so
what kind of games I like.
Yeah, definitely. Well, Matt, thank you for joining me.
Yeah,
Matt,
thank you for having me.
No problem. Keep watching the skies.
Matman and Tommen.
I don't know, but I like being Robin. But okay, yeah, sure.
Night. I got nothing else.
I don't know. Okay, bye, everybody.
Right.
Whoa, oh my god. What are you doing? No. Throw it. Do it. Throw the base. Fuck.